The harsh winter weather seems to have made an impact on everyone and everything, including the budget of the West Lafayette Street Department.
News 18's Samantha Tiki reports on how winter could force the city to dip into extra funds.
As spring approaches, winter is still making an impact on the area. West Lafayette Street Commissioner Dave Downey says the last several months of winter weather has their budget doubled from last year.
Last year we were about $126,000. This year we're way above $300,000.
From salt to replacing snowplow blades to employee overtime, Downey says it all adds up quickly.
To keep from hurting other programs, the mayor will have to consider dipping into the rainy day fund and paying for some of the salt and supplies that we have.
West Lafayette Mayor John Dennis says the city plans on asking for an additional appropriation of the rainy day fund at next month's city council meeting. But the mayor is confident that there is more than enough money available to make up for going over budget.
The rainy day fund has been able to grow because of the mild winters that we've had for the past several seasons. So this year, it's almost like that savings is being cashed. So we're now going to go ahead and get into those savings and make sure we're in a position to, if need be, rehab some of our equipment, try and deal with some of the damage that the roads have incurred over the winter season, and then do some preventive maintenance for the spring and summer of this year.
As for next year's budget, Downey says this year's harsh weather won't be a factor in deciding how much money should be spent.
Well, I don't expect any problems next year, but we'll plan on an average 22 to 32 inch snow, and we should be fine.
Although Downey isn't concerned about going over budget next year, he says weather permitting, the rainy day fund will help take care of any added cost.
When you have big storms, ice storms, wind storms, tornadoes, snowstorms, that's what the rainy day money's back there for.
In West Lafayette, Samantha Tiki, News 18.